going to show you how to make this really cool wreath plate today using some masking tape and some other really easy techniques. We're going to start by taking our masking tape and just putting it right down in the center of our piece. And then you can just go ahead and trace the inner circle there to sort of give you a guideline of where you're going to be working around. Then we're going to start masking off the pieces of the wreath here. So we'll have to do a couple of different times and do a different color each time. But basically, you're just going to take a piece of tape and work from the circle outward. And make those sort of trapezoid shapes all the way around the plate. Okay, now we have some tape laid down on the plate here, and we're just going to go ahead and paint with a couple of coats of the Lime Ricky. We're going to start out with that color. So just paint inside each of the spaces that you've created with the masking tape. Just a quick coat of paint. And then we'll just go around one more time and add a second coat. Okay, and then we'll give that just a minute to dry. Okay, now that this is dry, we're going to remove the tape from this part, and then we'll just add some more masking tape to create more shapes around the wreath and paint them in with a different color green. Okay, so now we have our second round of tape down, and we're going to take a shade darker green. This is Kermit, and do the same thing. So we're just going to do two quick coats of paint in the new spaces we've created. We'll just go around one more time and add a second coat of paint. Okay, so now we're going to take this tape off and do it one final time and fill in all the rest of the blank spaces we have on the plate. Okay, and then we'll do the last round of the pieces from the wreath with the darkest green. Same, just two swishy coats. All right, and then we'll just remove the last of the tape from the darkest green. Okay, so the next step is going to be to add some of the little berries. And you can see we have a couple of smudges of green, so first we'll take those off by using a pencil eraser and just erasing the paint from the surface of the platter. So just take your eraser. And it's okay if it leaves just a faint little stain because we are going to paint over it, so the underglaze will cover the light stain. Okay, so we're just going to use a round brush and some red paint to add the berries. And I'll just kind of press the brush down. It doesn't have to be a perfect circle, but it'll sort of give you that round shape. And then I'll grab a smaller brush so I can add a few smaller berries. Okay, so while we're waiting for the berries to dry, we're going to do the edge of the plate using the teal paint and a yellow sponge. So you'll just press the sponge against the edge of the plate and pull it along the rim to get that nice clean finish. And the harder you press on the sponge, the farther it will come over. So if you want it to be a thicker rim, just press a little bit harder and maybe get it a little loaded, more loaded with paint. You'll want to do this 3 times to make sure that the rim comes out nice and solid. Our next step is going to be to add the detail lines inside the pieces of the wreath. So on the lighter greens, we're going to use the darkest green paint that we have. So the Green Acres paint is going to be the detail on the lighter pieces of the wreath. So we'll just squeeze a little out, make sure it's flowing nice, and then we'll squeeze it out onto the piece and just create a couple of quick detail lines in some of the lighter sections. And then we'll move on and we'll use the teal fun writer to add the details in the darkest green. Now we'll use a number 2 pencil to sketch on whatever we want written on the piece. And then we'll use the teal paint and a liner brush to do the lettering on this piece. These letters are pretty skinny, so you're just going to want to be really light-handed when you paint them on. And if you have to go over some of your berries, it's okay. And for the very last step, we're just going to take the Rockin' Red Fun Writer and add an outline to the berries. And put some dots inside them. Okay, we're all finished. Our family Christmas wreath platter.